So, you might ask, why 40? Why do you see 40? And I just, during the pandemic, probably like many of you, I became a little sullen when we couldn't sing, when we couldn't do what we normally do in the time of the pandemic. So after a couple of months, I figured out that, of course, even though people couldn't sing together safely, the organ still had a profound voice. Are you hearing me okay?
Okay.
And so I committed to presenting something weekly that would put beauty in the context of faith through biblical readings, poetry, and all of this amidst the sights and the sounds of the cathedral. So in January, I started Facebook Living this, and all of a sudden I realized that sometimes 400 people a week would check in and see what we're doing. So I think that we were able to bring people closer to the cathedral and our mission out in beauty and hope. So the concept of beauty and hope was really to have a brief concert, provide scripture, provide poetry, and encourage people to open their hearts and their pocketbooks to give, because we know that many people suffered physically in the pandemic. So if there's anything that I forget to mention today, I've tried to make sure everything is in the program for you. If you get a chance, one window is especially inspiring to me, and you have to climb the loft to see it. Before I open the door, every time I see something that says, "Be ye doers of the word and not hearers only," it's the St. James window, completely inspiring every single time. And so I encourage you to put your faith in action. Let's say, spaces and seeing lots of photography come by. And all of a sudden, there was a stunning photo of the cathedral. And I immediately had to find out more about this work of art. So through a little bit of exploration, I discovered it was by John Derry. We struck up a little friendship, and I'd like to introduce him to you today because he has invested a lot, maybe his whole lifetime, leading him to be able to create something like this. So let's welcome John Derry.
At Omaha. I studied under Professor Peter Hill. was a real big influence on me. He came from the abstract expressionist school, and just the whole motivation of using, you know, what's in here. And I always describe it this way: what I want to do is take something in here and put it out there, where other people can see it. And to me, that's really the underpinnings of what art is. You know, you're taking something internal that only you see and converting it into a medium, like a print, that other people can see. And whether or not the people get the same emotional expressiveness out of that image that I got remains to be seen. And that's another wonderful thing about art. Each one of you will come to this image and get something different out of it. So I ended up leaving Nebraska, and I got my master's in a fine arts degree. And this is in 1983. And I spent a couple of years working for the Artisan Residence Program for the Nebraska Arts Council. My wife and I were out in Scottsbluff for 2 years working with the West Nebraska Arts Center. And it was in that period of time where the desktop computer was just happening, just becoming a thing. And computers, for the most part, first started out crunching numbers and then being able to edit words. And it was only about 1985 or so that the possibility of using a computer to manipulate or create imagery was happening. And I was just fascinated by that. I really wanted to get involved in it. So to make a long story not so long, I ended up in California working for a small software company that produced a niche of software that's called digital painting software. And what I was able to do, beginning with one company and then I went through a couple, we were able to literally, in looking in hindsight, who would have known this, we were somewhat the pioneers of creating digital paintbrushes, chalks, charcoals, pencils, with all of the nuances that you associate with the traditional mediums that they're emulating. And so that opened it up for a lot of people who otherwise probably weren't too interested in the computer, but when they realized, I can express myself through this thing, same thing, get what's in here, out there. And we managed to literally kind of create the niche of software that is called Natural Media Digital Painting Software. The application is called, still is around, will be 30 years old this year actually, is Painter. And it's now sold by Corel. But that software sort of created this whole idea of being able to craft artwork that seemingly looks like watercolors or oil paints or a pencil drawing. And for the longest time, Painter was the one application that really shined in that particular area. What's happened now, particularly with the takeoff of tablets, there are innumerable applications that also do this now. So in some small way, I like to, kind of pat myself on the back and say, we had a little part in creating that. And the greatest reward of it has been, as the years have gone by, people will send things and say, look, we did this with paint or whatever. And while the three of us, those two other programmers and myself, I'm an artist, so I didn't do the actual coding, but I was there to answer, like, should it do this or should it do that? You want it to go up or down? And so I was always there to kind of help guide them in how a tool would work from a traditional artist's sense. But those tools then became something that I see art all the time. It's very rewarding to see how much this tool took off and has been used literally worldwide. So.
Exciting. So this piece was created using his own tools. Very exciting. And just could you explain the relationship of the name Armor of Light to the game?
I knew you were going to put me on the spot.
Here it is, I'll let you.
Okay. I don't want to be accused of misquoting a saint. So St. Cecilia at one point made this comment, and it was an interview with an inventor and photographer. Where is it?
It's right here. Right
here. Oh. Oh, yeah. Arise, soldiers of Christ, cast off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. When I saw that phrase, that armor of light, just hit me. As an artist, you always want to somehow kind of push the direction of what people might think about a piece of art through a title. And armor of light was just such a stunning phrase. It's just as I said, the way that the light in this space is energized by being here, armor of light just really hit me. And it was like, that's the title of this piece. It can't be anything else. Armor of light is it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we just appreciate that. There's information about his website. And each creation of a print is unique. And so if you feel like you would like to have a print, you can discuss size or anything with him. And he has offered to give a percentage to the St. Vincent de Paul Society. Thank you, John, for creating a beautiful work for us.
Sure, thank you.
Windows, 12 movements, so some of